All right, Melora Hardin is the envy of our staff for two reasons. We're going to press a button, bring her up, and ask, Melora, do you want to discuss A, your handsome husband who set up the Skype call, or B, the glasses you were wearing before the call began, which our producers here say the best glasses they've ever seen?
Really? And they're good because they have that, you know, that thing that keeps you protected from your blue screen or whatever, the computer thing. They're kind of funky, right?
They are flattering. Really good. We'll show up the photo. I didn't know that your husband in real life plays your husband on the bold type.
He does. And he is handsome. And I think he's very cute.
And is it fun to work together, or is that ever too much time together?
Oh, no. It's fantastic to work together, especially because we're kind of dealing with some, like, sensitive things with Jacqueline and Ian's relationship. And that was something that I kind of pitched a long time ago, because both Gilbert and I, we've had a long marriage, a long relationship. We've known each other for like 35 years almost. So we kind of like this idea of really showing what it is to have a long-term relationship where they hit a rocky road, but they really do love each other and they are trying to work this through. And sort of what that looks like, you know, with history and children and lots of love.
Oh, I love the way you describe that. More bold type in a second, but I have to ask you about this. This Omaze cast thing where you did the coffee date with a yeah. guy from Greece?
Well, yeah, we're about to do it, actually. Oh, okay. The guy from Greece, he won. I think we're doing it later today or tomorrow, or it's very soon. Anyway, I'm excited about it. Yeah, it's a super fun idea, and it raised a lot of money for for underprivileged people that really need to be getting meals. So I'm very pleased that it raised good money for good things.
Glad to hear that. Back to the bold type series on the second half of season 4, and as you indicated, it deals with real stuff. It's not just all sort of gloss and glamour. And is that one of the things that you think keeps audiences engaged for 4 seasons now?
Yeah, I really love that about the show. It obviously is idealistic, but it also is realistic. And I think also the show has this uncanny ability to kind of be just the tiniest bit ahead of the wave of what's really going on in the world. The Tonight's episode, which I directed, and I'm also in, is called Snow Day. And it's a wonderfully kind of strangely, aligned, you know, episode with what everybody's been going through with the pandemic, because the whole cast gets stuck and kind of has to get grounded because there's all of New York gets shut down because of all the snow. And so people are, you know, having to be confronted with people that they may or may not want to be having conversations with right now. And I think that's, you know, that's something we've all been going through, being in this lockdown and trying to flatten the curve with COVID. So I think it's interesting that the episode is somehow kind of related to what we're all going through.
All right. I'll tell you what, I'll be honest with you. I'm not certain if this is a clip from tonight or previously, but we'll look at a clip from the bold type. Let's see.
Okay. My kids' school has just shut down, and they are predicting more snow within the next hour, which means that the buses and the subways are going to be affected. So I think everybody should work from home.
Wait, even me?
Especially you, Andrew. Oh, Jane, there you are. I know this is a very big day for you. Big launch.
Yeah.
Snow or no snow, I want to make sure you have everything you need.
Absolutely.
That's what I love to hear. Get home safely, everyone.
Uh-oh, that's where it starts. And you can see excellent snow in the background. You did a good job of directing that.
Thank you. Well, those were my
folks, the bold type.
Excellent job making the snow look that good.
It looked really good. Bold type tonight at 10 p.m. on Freeform. Thanks so much for joining us. If there was ever somebody to play Jennifer Gould in a movie, don't you think?
Oh, Melora.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah.